I want to preach to you the message this morning, knowing who you are. Knowing who you are in Christ Jesus. You are a special individual, amen, when you know Jesus. Jesus loved you so much, amen, he gave his life for you. You know that deep down inside of you, you know that he loved you and he cares for you. And he gives you that blessed hope, amen. He gives you that blessed hope because he loves you and cares for you. And you know, amen, that serving him, amen, serving him is the ultimate thing that he wants you to do, is to serve him and to honor him and uplift him, amen, to your fellow man. Amen. Glory to God. We need to tell others about Jesus. And we need, amen, to let others see Jesus in us. In Colossians, Paul is trying to get the church to realize who they are in Christ Jesus. And when he begins to start this, he says, if he then be risen with Christ, in verse, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. He says, set your affections on things above. And set them on things above and not on the earth beneath. Amen. See, sometimes we get so wrapped up where we are right now that we forget where we're going. Let me say that again, because somebody just turn me off. Turn me off like a radio. Turn the dial off. Amen. He says, set your affections on things above, not on the things of the earth. When our affections are set on things above, we live, amen, in that atmosphere, amen, knowing our hope is not on the things of this earth, glory to God, but it's in God, amen, who is, amen, in control of all things and seated there in the right hand of God in heaven above. And glory to God, when we serve him, amen, we have joy unspeakable and full of glory. And he goes on and he makes this mention here. When we get down to the 23rd verse, he says, and whatsoever you do, do it heartily as to the Lord and not unto men. Whatever you do. See, a lot of folks, amen, when their affection is set on things of the earth, they do it for the glory of men. Look at me. See what I've done. I got that done. I did that. Oh, the church ought to appreciate me because I gave a big donation today. What did you do it for? You did it to get praises of men. And the word of God teaches us if we are in tune with God, we do it for the glory of God. We don't do it, amen, to get a pat on the back from a man, a praise from a man. Glory to God, that ends there. But the praise of God, amen, lasts for eternity. It lasts for eternity. Do it as unto God and not unto men. And he stressed this twice. And if you look back at the 17th verse, he says very much the same thing. And whatsoever you do in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. So he's telling us twice. When God tells you something twice, you better listen. And you better obey. We ought to serve him with enthusiasm. We ought to come into church, amen, excited about worshiping God. Glory to God. Good morning, brother so-and-so. Good morning, sister so-and-so. Man, it's good to be in the house of God this morning. Are you ready to praise him with me? Amen. He's been good to me all week. Amen. He put food on my table. Glory to God. Amen. He healed my sickness and diseases. Glory to God. Amen. He kept me safe from old COVID this week. Glory to God. Amen. Give him the praise. Amen. Why can't we serve God like that? Why can't we serve God like that? Do it with enthusiasm. Whatever you do, do it heartily as to the Lord and not unto men. You can always measure how far a person will go in life by measuring their enthusiasm. Some of them ain't excited about nothing. Right? Ain't excited about nothing. Ain't going nowhere. Ain't been no, let me put it this way. You ain't been nowhere. You ain't going nowhere. Just sitting on the bench. Passing time. Some of you like that old song. Sitting on the dock of the bay. Watching the tide just roll away. Ain't doing nothing. Ain't getting the boat. Ain't got just sitting on the dock. Just sitting on the dock. I don't know where that came from. That's extra. Amen. Just extra. Glory to God. We don't have any enthusiasm left. I've seen folks excited about the work and what they're doing. They get so excited about that. I mean, they achieve great levels because of their enthusiasm. I mean, they're excited about what talent God has given them, and they're just taking it and running full throttle with it. But some of us, amen, we don't have enthusiasm. We have allowed Satan to steal it from us. And you know what will steal your enthusiasm level, amen? Let me tell you this, past sins. We allow Satan to hold our past over our head. You'll never amount to nothing. You never was nothing. You're never going to be nothing. I got news for that buzzard. Tell him, take a hike. Amen. Jesus Christ saved me from my past. He didn't save me in it. Amen. He saved me from it. He forgave me of my sins. He's cast them as far as east is from west. He said they'll never bother you again. They'll never trouble you. They're not a problem. They're not what's stealing your enthusiasm. It's Satan. Jesus says, hey, man, I'm going to give you full throttle and move right along. You got a new life in me. You got a new life in me. That's knowing who you are. I don't have to settle for less because I'm a king's kid. Hey, man, I've been adopted. I've been purchased by the blood, and I've been adopted. Glory to God. You don't hear much in the church now about the blood of Jesus. Oh, what can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me white as snow? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. It's the blood, amen, that was spilled on Calvary's hill, amen, that will cleanse us and make us whole again. Oh, I ain't letting Satan hold that pass over me. I mean, I'm putting it in the background and putting the metal to the pedal to the metal, amen. Yeah. Yeah, thank you, Lord, for helping me on that one. I almost forgot it. Amen. Yeah. But don't let Satan hold your past over you and steal your enthusiasm. Oh, not only that, well, he'll steal your enthusiasm with your past, but he'll come along and create a circumstances in your life. Anybody ever had one of them? Many times circumstances will drain us of our joy. Remember, there are many things that you have no choice over. Many circumstances will come up in your life you have no control over. Right? If you live any time, you're going to find that out. You have no control over. But you do have a choice. Listen to me. You do have a choice how much you will believe God to get you through. Right? Do you serve a big God? Is your God bigger than your circumstances? If you believe that, amen, he's going to get you through. And you're not going to be held down, amen. You're going to have that joy overflowing because, amen, even in your circumstances, you know God's got it. God's got this, amen. So don't let past sins, don't let circumstances, and don't let this one, this is a big one here, people. Many people drains us of our enthusiasm. We might be excited about doing what God has called us to do it, and we share it with somebody. Oh, I wouldn't do that. Oh, boy, if I listened to them, I wouldn't be standing here today. Some of them say, you know, make a good preacher. They didn't call me. God called me. God called you. He equips you. Amen. So don't let people steal your joy. Don't let people steal your joy. Don't let them drain you. Take the initiative and go to them with enthusiasm. Let it spill on them. Amen. Say, yeah, praise God. God called me. I'm still going. Where you at? Woo! Some of them 20 years ago told me I will never make it. Some of them said, I hope you build a church. I said, ain't no hope. Jesus called me to do it, and it's done. Amen. You're setting in it. Glory to God. Don't let people steal your joy. Don't let people. Don't let circumstances. Don't let past sin. And don't let criticism. Because people, amen, use that criticism. Criticism. When you're criticized, don't let it stop you. Amen. Just keep on going. If you know what God has called you to do, do it with Amen. Do it like you Superman. Amen. A Wonder Woman, whatever. Amen. I put the women in, I do. Do it, amen, with all your heart, with all your soul. Amen, with all your strength and joy. Keep on keeping on. Don't stop. I like to be criticized when God is working in me. Amen. Praise God. Criticize me all you want to. Amen. You can call me whatever you want to, but when he calls me, you can call me gone. Hello. Bye-bye. I'll see you. Amen. Later. Amen. Hope God gets hold of your heart. Don't let past failures hold you down. You know, whenever you get excited about doing something for God, Satan's going to try you. He's going to bring all of the things we just talked about. And you know, he's going to try to stop you. And he's going to bring up, amen, everything. And you might fail at what you're doing. Hello? But don't stop. Don't stop. Don't stop. When I was trying to learn to play the bass, nobody wanted to play the bass until I started playing it. Didn't look like everybody and the brother come along. Well, I wasn't much good because I didn't know nothing. Didn't nobody teach me anything. Whatever I got it on my own and through the Lord Jesus Christ, you know. And then, you know, I failed many times. It probably didn't sound good. But somebody else come along, you know, then he said, well, so-and-so can play the bass, and you let him play. Well, if they wanted to play, they should have been playing a long time ago. God told me I could do it. I prayed to God. He said, you can do it. I fail many times, and I'm saying this to you, failure, amen, it's never final. Failure is never final. Everyone has failed at something. Little boys know what it is. It's like to strike out in that baseball game or to miss the basket, amen, when shooting a basketball, or drop a pass, amen, in the football game, or get a pass intercepted five times, right, Chris? Amen. Get an interception five times. You fail many times. Whenever you're attempting to do something, you will make mistakes. You will fail, but get back up. Brush your bridges off because, hey, man, you got a next round coming up. Amen. Boy, you're going to get to bat again. You're going to get to shoot the ball again. You're going to get to catch a pass again. Don't let failure stop you. Glory to God. Amen. If I had failures to stop me from preaching, amen, because I wasn't that good, I wouldn't be here today, and I'm still not that good. But glory to God. God loves, amen, a person who will try. Amen. Failure is never final, and failure is a great teacher. The question is, are you a good learner? Are you a good learner? So I'm going to serve Christ with enthusiasm. Don't you? I'm getting a little slower and older now, you know. But I still like to serve him with all I got. I might not seem like it at times, you know, and you might not seem like it at times. But inside, I'm bubbling over. I'm bubbling over. Oh, man, I love to talk, amen, when it's about the Word of God. God has given me so much knowledge and wisdom over the years in the Word. And sometimes I wish I could remember it all, and sometimes I don't until somebody says something about it. You know, when they say something about it, it triggers, you know, that's what I learned this way. You know, this is what I learned back years ago. And then it brings, I like the Holy Spirit. Jesus said, he'll bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I taught you. Yeah, and just, it just flows. And I love talking about God. And I like to talk to him about it with enthusiasm. Sometimes I might be sarcastic, you know, in a way I deliver it. But don't pay no attention to that. I'm just trying to get you to listen and learn, you know. Go ahead and just jump in with me. Amen. On a hot day, you know, everybody like to go to the pool if they can swim. Please don't jump in the pool with them because I can't swim. You probably have to get me out of the pool. But, amen, but I like to use it in a little analogy here. I like, amen, on a hot day, consider the Word of God the pool, and just jump on in with me, amen, because I'm going to swim through that one, amen. I can do that one. I've been taught by the Master, amen. I can swim through that one. We can get through that one. Just jump in together like we are this morning. You know, one of the other things, amen, knowing who you are, you know, you serve Christ with enthusiasm, but you serve him with determination as well. Anybody ever seen a hard-headed person? Some of your wives say, "Oh, yeah, I'm married to him." Hard-headed. You ever been called hard-headed? You ever wonder why they called you hard-headed? Because you're so determined to do it right or wrong. You was determined you was going to do it. Right or wrong. Come on. Y'all don't say something, I'm going to park here. Because I was thinking about it. I struck up a nerve, amen, on some of it. Amen. Your determination give you that hard-headedness to stick to it. Determined. See, Jesus, amen, wants us to have that determination like we used to when we was a kid, you know. Because you was a hard-headed when you was a teenager, weren't you? With age comes wisdom, and then you realize you weren't that smart. But you was determined. And that's what I want you to get in your mind. You're determined. See, God wants us to be determined and have that hard-headedness when it comes to serving him. You know, Jesus said this, amen, over in the Gospel of Luke. No one have to put in his hand to the plow and look it back. It's fit for the kingdom of God. Did you hear what he said? No one, when he's put his hand to the plow and look it back, is fit for the kingdom of God. Oh, you got to have a determination, amen. Keep your eyes straight ahead and keep on going. So he also tells us over in Galatians 6:9, let us not get tired of doing what is right. For after a while, we'll reap a harvest of blessing if we don't get discouraged and give up. If you don't get discouraged and give up. Boy, over the years, I've seen people say, God has called me to do this. God has called me to do that. Next thing you know, it went good for a few weeks or months, and then next thing it fizzled out. If God called you to do it, he called you to do it forever. Amen. There's no turning back. Keep on getting it. Amen. Keep on getting it. Listen, folks, amen. God wants us to have a determination, amen. It's a mindset. It's not something we do once in a while. It's a determination. It's an attitude of life to keep on keeping on. Keep on keeping on. Remember, the oak tree is nothing more than a little acorn who refuses to give up. I thought I should throw that in there since it's fall of the year, you know. You hear what I said, amen? The oak tree is nothing more than a little acorn who refuses to give up. Oak's pretty good strong wood, isn't it, Frank? Oak wood is strong. Hardwood, it's called hardwood. Thank you. I remember something about it. I ain't that good a carpenter, but I do remember a little bit about hardwood, amen? Successful people are not always extraordinary people, but they are just ordinary people who has an extraordinary determination. Whew, I like that one. Amen. Determination is not the absence of fear, but many times I have been determined to do a job for God, but my heart was scared to death. But God, amen, through his Holy Spirit and power, gave me that hard-headed stick-to-it, amen, attitude, and I got through it. And do it with enthusiasm. Amen. Determination. But friend, I'm afraid to tell you, in our churches, we got what Rick Warren called risk takers. They're not afraid to take a risk. We also got some caretakers who's not afraid to care for one another or care for the things of the Lord. But we also got some undertakers. Some of you didn't get that one, haven't we? We also got some undertakers. They kill the momentum. They kill the determination. They kill the enthusiasm. We should never, amen, allow those individuals to stop us from doing what God's called us to do because we know who we are in Christ Jesus. They just need to know him. Let me put it that way. They just need to know him. They just need to come to know him as we know him. Because not only do we have enthusiasm and determination, but we got a vision. Amen. The ability to see. Ability to see. The Bible tells us in Proverbs 29:18, where there's no vision, the people perish. The common denominator in great leaders is the ability to see where they are going, to see where they want to accomplish for the Lord, amen, to see how to get there and to see how to overcome obstacles. See, the prophets, amen, y'all remember the prophets in the Bible? The prophets saw first, they saw most, and they saw furthest into the future. For one of the greatest sermons that was preached in the last century was by Martin Luther King Jr., amen, who preached the sermon, "I Have a Dream." And because he was so determined, amen, and did it with enthusiasm, the Washington, D.C. leaders, amen, passed the Civil Rights Bill. He did that, amen, because he saw what his people need for the future. I have a dream. You see furthest, amen, into the future. When people buy into the dreams of a leader, they buy into the leadership. Nothing happens until you start dreaming, because nothing happens until you see the future. Your business will never be greater than your vision, and the vision will never be greater than its leader. The same can be said for your family as well. Your family will never be greater than the vision you have for your family. And I think every parent should have a vision that they want to see their children, amen, be successful, be good citizens, and serve God most of all. And when you have that type of vision for your family, you can see God change our society. The reason our society is going down because we have lost the vision in the home. Come on. What goes on in the home goes on in the church, and what goes on in the church goes on in the nation. So it feeds from the home. Our visions for our home need to be put back in place. Moms and dads, male and female, mind you, constituting the family, raising, as mom and dad, raising your children and nursing them in the Word of God. When we get that vision back into our homes, then our homes will be great again. And our homes great again, our churches will be great again. And with our churches great again, our nation will be great again. But it won't happen until we serve God with enthusiasm, determination, amen, and glory to God, have a vision for that very thing. In concluding today, every day has these three elements in it that I just spoke about. Determination, excitement, and vision. When you wake up in the morning and you see that sunrise, you begin to get excited about what this day holds for you, right? Some of you thought you're dreading what this day is going to hold for you, but you should be excited because it's the day the Lord has made. And the Bible said, "I will rejoice and be glad in it, no matter what takes place." I'm excited about what this day holds. Because when you get out of the bed and you're excited about serving God, you're going to ask him, "God, what will you have me to do today?" Whatever the amen God gives you in that day, it's what he wants you to do, good or bad. Because sometimes he wants you to take the bad and turn it into good. Huh? And if you got a good day, he wants you to encourage somebody along the journey. Every day, amen, God wants you to achieve something for him. Do it heartily as unto the Lord, whatever you find yourself doing, right? That's what our verse taught us, amen. The main verse today in 323 and 317. Do it. Because excitement means, hey, I'm on God's team. And we ain't never lost. Let me remind you again, we never lost. Never lost. I'm excited about being on God's team. And determination says, I can't give up. I'm not going to give up. Even when Satan got to me, pinned to the mat, you know, I talked about wrestling a couple weeks ago. When I got pinned to the mat, when Ric Flair got me, amen, old Satan got me in a figure four. Don't give up. Amen. Don't give up. Don't pat the mat giving up. Get up. Get up. Reverse it. Because I've seen them reverse it on him. Hello? I've seen them reverse it on him. Put the devil in the full figure. Amen. or whatever they call it, amen. Amen. Win. Never give up. And see what God sees through your vision. See what God sees and what God wants you to accomplish in life. The difference between who you are and who you want to be is what you do. I'm going to say that again. The difference between who you are and who you want to be is what you do. Bill Phillips said that. Amen. But God says, amen, I'll be your source. I'll be your strength. Just be enthused. Do it with determination and see what I see. And we're going to accomplish great things. Amen. Because I know who I am in Christ Jesus.
We read of a place that's called heaven. It's made for the pure and the free. These truths in God's word He has given. How beautiful heaven must be. The angels so sweetly are singing. Betrayals and failures destroy. Joy, how beautiful.